answer to the prayers of a mother. An answer to the many prayers of a mother, the prayers of a sister, for kid brother, and God has done it. We are so grateful and we appreciate God. I request that Mom prays for our pastor, our speaker.
Amen. Bwana asifiwe, let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we are so humbled at the throne of mercy this afternoon. We want to thank you for air that we breathe. We want to thank you that we are here this afternoon. We came because you called us, my Father. We came because we love you. But above everything, we came because we know you love us so very much. This afternoon, my Lord, you have set a table before us. We pray that, my Father, we shall receive from you and you only. We pray for the anointing of the hour this afternoon, even for Pastor Brian. We pray that, my Father, you will speak, my Father, through him, the only the oracles of God. I pray that, my Father, we shall be blessed together, Lord, and may this be a turning point of many this afternoon, that, Lord, we shall know what your love is unto us, in Jesus' mighty name. I pray for the anointing of God once again, in Jesus' mighty name. We do pray, believe, and give thanks. Amen, amen and amen.
Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
Well, this is a joy.
Ini DOI?
Yeah, it's also that. It is a joy to be here.
Yeah, ni furaha kukuwa hapa.
I'm excited at the opportunity to be here today.
Na niko na furaha sana kupata huu wakati wa kuwa mahali hapa.
We are seated there and saying this is a highly emotional meeting.
Dada yetu amesema ya kwamba ni iko na emotion ya kipekee.
The emotion is contagious.
Iko na emotion ya kipekee sana.
All right. So just before we get into the word, we'd like to just drink some love. If I will invite the worship team to come on over here for just a minute.
Ningependa kuharibu worship team wakuje mahali hapa.
But as they come up,
wanapokuja,
you do not need a song, right? You can just lift up your voice wherever you are.
Inua
and just tell Jesus,
yuko.
Yes, I know that you have loved me, but I pray that you will open my eyes today.
Uambia
right
yes,
here,
yukomba,
right now, that I may see you for who you really are.
Fungua
that I may take
yako.
In your love for what it really is.
Ini
come on, do not be afraid of your neighbor. They do not have a place they can take you to. I want you to just break that alabaster jar open as if you're never going to need it again. Just break it up completely and lift up your voice. And at the top of your voice, if you can just commune with the Father, if you can just love on him, if you can just pour out your praise and your worship, if you can give him your highest right this instance in the name of Jesus, if you could do just one favor and keep from praying. I'm not asking you to pray. I'm asking you to give our high worship to the King of Kings. I'm asking you to give our high worship to the Lord of Hosts, the God mighty in battle, the one that is our rescuing knight, the one that has delivered us out of the darkness into his marvelous light, the one that has clothed us with a fresh new garment of praise, the one that has allowed us to know that we are now owned, that we are now a people. Scripture says that he came to the world and it received him not, yet to all who received him, to all who believed in his name, he gave them the power, the right, the privilege to be called sons of God. Come on, if you understand right here in this house that the Father has called you son, the Father has called you my child, the Father has said you are my own, I am well pleased in you, I love you, I love you, I love you. If you understand that, won't you lift up your voice and as if you're crazy for just about 1 minute, won't you lose it all and give it to Jesus? Rika mama yando robosi pia kasata yandere reposa. Rika mama yandere bori piria kashanda rara posi piria kaya yandara reposa. Repa kanda rara posi kishindi riposa. Jesus said that when the Holy Spirit has come, he shall lead you into all truth. I want to ask that you will allow the Holy Spirit right here in this meeting, that he will lead you into the truth, that Jesus has loved you with such an extravagant love that you will be led to that truth right here. It's not going to happen by power. It's not because of the words I'm going to speak. It is definitely not by might. He says, but by my spirit. That's what the Lord said. Allow the Holy Spirit to break everything within you, every barrier, every wall, to move every barricade, to destroy every wall. Come on, lift up your voice and let God do his thing inside of you. You're asking God, let every God fall down. Let every man be called a liar. Let only your voice over me remain. Your voice roaring over me, saying, my son, I love you. My daughter, I love you. My child, I love you. And it doesn't matter what other voice says otherwise. Let those voices fade away this instant in the name of Jesus. Yes, that's right. You can push up for just one more minute. For just one more minute. One more minute. Let every other voice fade away. Until there's only the voice of Jesus speaking to your mind, speaking to your heart. Yes. Ah. Gods fade away. Let all the other names fade away. Till there's only you. Let all the other names fade away. Let's sing, let all the other names fade away. Let all the other names fade away. Till there's only you. Till there's only you. Let all the other names fade away. Oh, let all the other names fade away. Till there's only you. Let all the other names fade away. Oh, let all the other names fade away. Till there's only you. Let all the other names fade away. Let all the other names fade. Till there's only you. Say, till there's only you. Let all the other names fade away. Let all the other names fade away. Let all the other names fade. Till there's only you. Till there's only you. The names fade away. Hanarara bossa, seka sanda yanarara bossi yanare. Kera baba soko yanarara basa ehara. Shita zenerele bossa. Hallelujah. I know there is different of us gathered in this place today. I know there are some of us that have been are accepted and approved and affirmed, and there are people that have loved us and they have told us they loved us, and it's true, they really do. But if for a second you would allow even that name to just fade away. On the other hand, we have people in this place that have expected and waited for love from people, and it was expected that it should be given to you, but it wasn't given to you, and that's a name. But even for that, if you let it fade away until there is only Jesus roaring over your life right this moment, saying to you that I love you, I accept you, I approve of you, you are my child, I affirm you in the name of Jesus. Won't you lift up your hands and for just one more minute say, yes, Lord, yes, you alone, you're all that matters, you're all that matters. Some of us, the Lord is saying he'd like to love us. He's wanted to love us. His agenda since before you were created was just to love you, was just to love you. But some of you have put up walls towering up so high the master cannot get to where you are. Right this instant, he's saying if you would allow him, he'd like to bring down those walls. He'd like to bring down those barricades. He'd like to destroy those barriers, because the master is after your heart. 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 Come on, lift up your voice and allow him to break down every wall and every wall barrier, every barricade right now. Presence in this house today, Lord Jesus. We worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, Lord God Almighty, we worship you in this house today. We allow you to have your way. We allow you to pull doors. We allow you to move what needs to be moved. We came because we need a Savior. And we want to proclaim in this house here and now that Jesus Christ, the living God, he is our Savior. He is the reigning King. He is the champion in this house. He is speaking. His voice is roaring over every other voice. Jesus alone, we recognize, acknowledge you alone as Lord and King, our rescuing knight, our shield, our steel, our defense, our high and rescuing God. You alone, precious King. We love you and we give you praise. We ask that it will please you to do in this meeting with what you have intended to do, right? Like you have from the beginning, oh God. Continue to do what you have intended to do with this meeting since creation, oh God. If there is a thing you have wanted to do with this meeting, oh God, we ask that you will do it. Let nothing stand in your way of doing it. We love you, we love you, we love you. But our prayer is that you will ask, you'll cause us to love you the more. It will cause the eyes of our understanding to be open to see you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, if you can put your hands together. Put a shout in your mouth and glorify the name of Jesus. Come on, you can do better than that. Hallelujah. Give your neighbor a high five. Tell them Jesus loves you.
Salimia rafiki yako, mwambie Yesu anakupenda.
Come on, if you can turn to one more person, tell them God is not mad at you.
Unaweza pindukia mwingine, mwambie Yesu anakupenda.
He is madly in love with you.
Anakupenda zaidi.
As you continue to sit, find one more person, tell them God is not mad at you.
Tunapoendelea kuketi, angalia mwingine, mwambie Yesu anakupenda.
He is madly in love with you.
Anakupenda zaidi.
God is not mad at you.
Mungu waja kukasirikia wewe.
He's madly in love with you.
Anakupenda zaidi.
It's interesting to speak at a ladies' meeting because you can say things like, you can turn to your neighbor and tell them with an attitude
that God is not mad at you.
He's mad in love with you. If you want to find one more neighbor, put some attitude in it and tell them God's not mad at you. Or he mad in you now. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. What a joy and what a great privilege to be here in this meeting DOI February 2019. What an absolute joy.
Yeah,
I'd like to say thank you to our mom, Pastor Alice Kimani.
Nashukuru wa mom, Pastor Alice.
President DOI. Come on, make some noise.
DOI.
We bless the Lord and for the team that has allowed me to stand here today. No be small thing.
Tunashukuru Mungu kwa sababu ya wote ambao wamenikubalia kuwa mahali hapa siku ya leo.
And to say thank you to all the sons of impact that are in the house. Make some noise for my brothers up in this place.
Kwa sababu ya wana wa impact katika nyumba.
Thank you for coming. Such an honor. The Lord bless you.
Asanteni kwa kuja, ni furaha sana kukua pamoja nanyi.
Special mention to this great MVPs, Pastor David Kibera. Make some noise for Pastor David Kibera. Make some great noise for Reverend Francis Omedo.
Shangilia Reverend Omedo Francis.
Amen. We bless the Lord. I know their schedules yesterday. They were traveling all over for different things, but they made sure they were here. I bless the Lord for you, great.
Tunashukuru Mungu wamekuwa na wakati mwingi wa kutembea kutoka jana hapa na pale, lakini siku ya leo wameweza kuja mahali hapa.
And for all of you that are here.
Na kwa wote ambao mko mahali hapa.
Especially the people that are here on midterm break, our high schoolers.
Sana sana wale wako kwa midterm break.
Karibuni sana. You came right on time.
Mlikuja wakati unaofaa.
The people that are in charge of making your schedules are in the spirit.
Wakati watu walio kanisani walitayarisha wakiwa katika roho.
In case we have some visitors, my name is Brian Mwashigadi.
Kama kuna mgeni, mimi naitwa Brian Mwashigadi.
I am born again, I love Jesus.
Nimeokoka na mpenda Yesu.
He's the solid rock of my salvation.
Yeah, ndiye nguvu za wokovu wangu.
I received him on the 17th of March in 2006.
Nilimpokea tarehe 17 mwezi wa 3 mwaka wa 2006.
It was a Friday evening during a weekend challenge.
Ilikuwa siku ya Ijumaa jioni kukiwa na weekend challenge.
And every time I stand in a place like this to minister, it takes me back to that day.
Na kila wakati ninaposimama ili kuhudumu nakumbukanga hiyo wakati.
Because where would I be but for the grace of God?
Kwa sababu ni wapi ningekuwa isipokuwa ni kwa neema ya Mungu.
It absolutely warms my heart to think that Jesus is all my wealth.
Inanifurahisha moyo sana ya kwamba Yesu yuko ndani yangu.
And maybe that's just a thing that us pastors like to say.
Na hiyo labda ndio sisi kama wachungaji tunapenda sana kusema.
But it is also the one truth of my life.
Lakini ni ukweli katika maisha yangu.
That without Jesus my life falls apart.
Ya kwamba kama si Yesu maisha yangu imekuwa imeharibika.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I am a member of ladies group number 6 since I was, I think, born.
Mimi ni member wa ladies group number 6 tangu nilipozaliwa.
Uko ndio kikombe imetoka, ilikuwa uko last month, eh?
Amen.
Alafu pia mimi ni member wa group number 27 since not so... Because the two ladies that you saw here belong to those two groups. My mom is in ladies group number 6.
Mama yangu ni wa group number 6.
And my sister is in group number 27, Elizabeth.
Na dada yangu ako group number 27.
No, na kikombe imetoka kwetu, ikarudi tu kwetu. Sasa, in other words, unaweza sema mimi ni dual citizen kwa DOI, sawa?
Amen.
Wonderful. We want to go straight to the word for just a short time.
Tunataka kuenda kwa neno kwa muda mchache tu.
The theme is, as I have loved you.
Theme ni kwamba kama nilivyo kupenda.
As I have loved you.
Kama nilivyo kupenda.
It comes from the book of John chapter 13.
Kitabu ya Yohana mlango wa 13.
From verse 34.
Mstari wa 34.
And these are the very words of Jesus.
Izi ni, haya ni maneno ya Yesu.
It's easy to know if you have a Bible like mine because the words of Jesus are in red.
Itakuwa rahisi kama uko na Biblia kama yangu tukiendelea kusoma.
He's speaking to his inner circle, the disciples.
Alikuwa anaongelea katika wanafunzi.
This was not one of the teachings on the Mount of Olives. This was not one of the teachings to the multitudes.
He
was speaking to the people that he had poured out all his life into. And so that tells you at least one thing about this thing. That these were heartfelt words. These words are also coming just a few hours before Jesus is crucified. That also tells you that these are passionate words.
That
they are words he expected will survive whatever will come. And survive they did, because more than 2,000 years later we are hearing about these words. Not just because they were written, but because the people that were given these words treasured these words up in their heart like Mary. And they carried these words out. One year and 2 years and 3 years and 10 years. And so on and so forth until we are here in
2019.
And now when we can read these words in John chapter 13 verse
34.
It does not sound like a Greek thing that has never been tested. It is believable because there were people that actually got down to do. And so it's as if the baton is being handed over to you. Listen, James says.
Yesu akasema.
James says.
Oh. Yakobo akasema,
for him who knows what is right to do,
yeye ambaye anajua vizuri vya kufanya,
and does not do it,
na hafanyi hivyo,
for him it is sin.
Yeye huwa anafanya dhambi.
So in this meeting, after we have shared everything,
kwa hivyo katika mkutano huu ambao baada ya kusoma kila kitu,
and you have heard what is right to do,
na umeshasikia kile ambacho
unafaa kufanya, and you fail to do it,
na ukose kufanya,
for you it is sin.
Kwako ni dhambi.
Why sin is because you'll be dropping the baton.
Kwa nini? Kwa sababu umeshapewa na umeachilia.
So the people that are coming up after you in your very own house will have missed to see a working example.
Kwa hivyo wale watu ambao wanakuja kwa nyumba yako, wale jamii yako, watakosa ili neno usipolifanya.
The people that you'll be mentoring will have missed to see a working example.
Wale watu ambao unakuza na kuwafundisha watakosa hili neno.
The people that you're interacting with, even in the matatu, perfect strangers will have missed to see a working example.
Wale watu ambao unatangamanika na wao watakosa kupata hili neno.
So failing to carry out these words of Jesus,
kwa hivyo kukosa kubeba hili neno la Yesu,
will be putting the entire thing at fault. You will be ruining the entire plan.
Utakuwa unaharibu kila kitu.
Because then you will be ruining the chances of anyone else that is a believer, a faithful one, to go and preach to these other people.
Kwa sababu utaharibu ile nafasi mtu mwingine angesikia na apokee na aweze kuhubiria
mwingine. The people that you are sharing a flat with.
Wale watu ambao tunaishi kwa nyumba moja.
If you don't carry out these precious words of Jesus.
Usipobeba hili neno la Yesu mzuri.
And they see you and they know you're a believer.
Na wakuone na wanajua ya kwamba wewe ni muumini.
They will not find it believable when any other believer comes in the future to tell them.
Hawataiamini hata muumini mwingine akikuja kuwaambia.
Because they will listen, they will look at the example of you that did not carry them.
Kwa sababu wataangalia mfano wako wewe ambao hujafanya vizuri.
Listen, Matthew chapter 7 verse 20. Before Jesus says,
Mathayo mlango wa 7 mstari wa 10 na wa 34 unasema,
in the message paraphrase, allow me to just quote it. It says that these words I speak to you are not homeowner improvements to your standard of living.
Haya maneno ambayo nimeyanena sio kwa sababu ya,
they are not homeowner improvements. They are not just additions to your standard of living.
Sio ya kuongezea tu katika maisha ya ile tunaishi.
He says, these words I speak to you are foundational words.
Hizi maneno ambayo nimenena kwenu ni kama msingi wa dunia.
They are words to build a life upon.
Ni maneno ya kujenga maisha ya mtu.
He says, anybody that takes these words of mine and builds their life upon them.
Kila mtu ambaye sikia hii maneno na kujenga msingi wa wake ndani yake.
I shall liken them to a carpenter that built his house upon the rock.
Iyo itakuwa kama nyumba ambayo imejengwa katika mawe.
And the rains fell.
Na mvua ikanyesha.
And the winds blew.
Na upepo ukaipiga.
But the house on the rock stood firm.
Lakini nyumba ilisimama hima.
Listen, beloved, every time you read these words and what we are just about to share, every time you read what Jesus is saying,
wakati wote unaosoma maneno Yesu alisema,
and you fail to carry these words out,
na unakosa kufanya,
because you are feeling a certain way,
kwa sababu kuna vile una,
because you think the person next to you is not deserving for you to be kind to them. What you're doing is not just making yourself feel better. You are absolutely ruining the plan that God will have wrought through your life.
Amen.
Here is one truth that I believe. This is one truth that I believe. That this Bible is the infallible word of God. That this is where you cannot find fault in it. If it says I am blessed, I am blessed. Whether I feel like it or not, I am blessed. Whether the things around me, the circumstances show that I am blessed or not, I am blessed.
Listen,
if scripture says I am healed, it doesn't matter that I am laid on in the bed for a few days. If it said it, then I believe it. Therefore, that does not just apply for the feel-good scriptures that we read. It also applies for the things that you read and they absolutely annoy you. Like what we are just about to look at. Jesus said to the disciples,
Yesu akasema kwa wanafunzi,
a new commandment I give to you,
nimewapatia agano jipya,
that you love one another,
ya kwamba penda jirani
as
yako,
I have loved you,
kama vile nilivyowapenda,
that you also love one another,
ya kwamba penda huyo mwingine.
There is repetition in there for emphasis.
Kuna kurudiwa katika hiyo maneno.
He says, I'm giving you this new commandment,
ya kwamba nawapatia.
Not new because it has just dropped from somewhere else. But new because there is a new assignment placed on it now. Love one another as I have loved you. That you also love one another. Then he says, by this everyone will know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another. By this the world will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. By this your husband or your wife shall know that you are my disciples if you love one another. By this your neighbors and your boss shall know that you are my disciples. Interesting that he did not say by your testimony will they know. He did not say by the way you dress or by the words that you speak in church. He did not say by the height that you lift your hands in worship shall you be known as my disciples. He doesn't say by the way you serve in church, by the way you come so early during the express service, way before bishop has arrived. Not that those are bad things, those are expected things. But he says, by this shall you know that they shall everyone know that you are my disciples if you love one another. And Paul asks in 1 Corinthians 13 that if I speak in the tongues of angels, if I move mountains, if I cast out demons, if I make sure that I support all the church projects, if I go to every funeral in this AKZ, if I attend DOI from January to November, if I sponsor all the cakes single-handedly, but I have no love, I am like a noisy symbol.
Mimi nitakuwa kama
I am like a creaking gate. I am like a door that is not greased.
Yani nitakuwa tu kama Mungu hakunivunja.
I am like an old engine.
Yeah, nitakuwa kama ile engine ambayo ni mzee kabisa.
In other words, I am just a noise maker.
Yani nitakuwa tu napiga kelele.
Little wonder Jesus asks in Matthew chapter 7 verse 23.
Mathayo sura ya 7 mstari wa 23.
That you shall come to me and they shall say, Lord, but we cast out demons in your name.
Ya kwamba utakuja kwangu mkisema Bwana tulifukuza mapepo kwa jina lako.
Oh, but we healed the sick in your name.
Hata tuliponya wagonjwa kwa jina lako.
Oh, we wrought miraculous wonders in your name.
Tulifanya miujiza kwa jina lako.
And he shall say to them, I never knew you, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. Why, pray tell, would he say this to such people? Because the answer is, by this you shall be known that you are my disciples.
Kwa sababu jibu ni ya kwamba kwa hili mtajulikana
ninyi
wanafunzi wangu mnapopendana.
I want us to just look at it. He says, because he says, as I have loved you.
Nataka tuangalie tena kwa sababu nasema kama vile nilivyowapenda.
Therefore love one another.
Kwa hivyo penda mwingine.
The premise of John chapter 13 is interesting.
Ahadi ya Yohana 13 inapendeza sana.
The setting of John chapter 13 is interesting. Mahali ambapo inatendekea.
Yeah, mahali ambapo inatendekea inapendeza sana.
Ndio hiyo sasa.
Amen.
It is very interesting.
Inapendeza zaidi.
Now Jesus is just having this feast. John calls it the Passover.
Yohana anaita Passover.
And he's seated with his disciples.
Ameketi na wanafunzi wake.
Now it's just a few hours before he's taken up to be crucified.
Masaa tu machache kabla hajapelekwa msalabani.
Now when supper is already going on.
Wakati supper ilikuwa inaendelea.
Jesus.
Yesu.
The Bible says, verse 3 of John chapter 13, allow me to just read it in English. It says, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands and that he had come from God and was going to God, rose from supper, laid aside his garments, took a towel and girded himself. After that, he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wash them and to wipe them with the towel with which he was girded. Then verse 6, he came to Simon Peter and Simon said to him, Lord, are you washing my feet? I want to pause for just a minute there. Now I'm going to that because we are saying Jesus is saying love one another as I have loved you.
Tunaenda hapo kwa sababu Yesu amesema pendaneni kama vile nilivyowapenda.
That is important because by the time Jesus is coming to say those words.
Hiyo inapendeza kwa sababu wakati Yesu alipokuwa anakaribia kusema hii maneno.
He has already washed the disciples' feet.
Alikuwa tayari ameosha wanafunzi miguu.
He has already washed even the one that was betraying him.
Alikuwa ameosha hata yule ambaye alimsaliti.
He has already washed the one that was going to deny him.
Alikuwa ameosha hata yule ambaye alimkana.
He is washing the one that was going to doubt that he is risen.
Alikuwa ameosha hata yule alikuwa anaenda ana hamuamini kama yeye ni mwana wa Mungu.
And it doesn't mention the intensity with which he scrubbed their feet.
Na hasemi chochote kuhusu kuosha miguu.
I believe it is intentional.
Naamini ni kama tu alifanya kimakusudi.
Because he did the job uniformly.
Kwa sababu alifanya kazi.
He cleaned the betrayer the same way he cleaned the one he loved the most.
Aliosha ule msaliti kama vile aliosha ule mwingine.
And realize it says this verse 3.
Na verse 3 inasema,
Jesus knowing that the Father had given all things to his hands and that he had come from God and was going to God, rose up and started to do the thing. In other words, that the thing that was pushing Jesus to do whatever he was doing right here
ile jambo ambalo lilimsukumia Yesu kufanya ile ambayo alifanya
was knowing where he was coming from.
Alikuwa anajua mahali ametoka.
Where he was going.
Na pahali anapoelekea.
He had the example of God.
Alikuwa na mfano wa Mungu.
See, he was not worried. He was not worried.
Hakuwa anaogopa.
Jesus was affirmed.
Yesu alikuwa amesimama.
Because long before this, when he was starting his ministry.
Kwa sababu anapokuwa akianzia huduma yake.
The heavens opened up.
Mbingu zilifunguka.
And a voice came from heaven.
Na sauti ikatoka
right in the Jordan and said, this is my son.
Hapo na ikasema ya kwamba huyu ni mwana wangu.
I am well pleased.
Ambaye nimempenda sana.
That affirmation was beautiful.
Hapo hiyo imani ilikuwa mzuri sana.
It allowed Jesus to know that there is a place I am coming from.
Ilimpatia Yesu kujua ya kwamba kuna mali nimetoka.
Not that he did not know it.
Si eti hakuwa anajua.
But it sure did feel good to know or to hear it being said again.
Lakini alisikia vizuri kusikia limesemwa tena.
Because if you want to put this into points,
kwa sababu ukitaka kujua hivi vizuri,
it matters, number one, it matters who loves you.
Inalingana ni nani anayekupenda.
It matters who loves you.
Inalingana sana ni nani anayekupenda.
Simple illustration, especially for the ladies. Yeah, actually just primarily for the ladies.
Kuelezea vizuri sana sana kwa wadada.
If you're going to town and you sit in a Zuri matatu.
Kama unaenda town na unapanda Zuri.
And you sit just somewhere inside, in between, yeah.
Na unaketi hapo katikati.
And then some guy that you have never met at all.
Na mtu ambaye hujamwahi muona tena.
Who is the one that is beating the ribs? My grandmother says beating the ribs of the car.
Ule ambaye anapiga gari huku kando.
Yeye ndio anajaza gari anashika. Ndio hiyo sasa ndio hiyo. Yeah. That person, if he just sits next to you after gari imejaa.
Yes, akikuja aketi karibu nawe baada ya gari imejaa.
And then says to you.
Alafu akwambie,
"Sister nakupenda."
Dada nakupenda.
What do you think of that person?
Unafikirianga aje kuhusu
huyo? Thank you. Somebody thinks they are mad.
Unafikiria hai
somebody else thinks
wazimu.
Excuse me?
Wengine wanauliza, excuse me?
You know you're thinking, how can you ruin my day like that? It's too early in the morning.
Unasema unaweza niharibia siku aje?
Now, change that just a little bit.
Ebu bandilisha hiyo kidogo.
You're a single lady.
Wewe ni haujaolewa.
That guy says the same thing to you.
Na huyo mtu anakuja anasema
hiyo maneno. You still think, yuck.
Bado unafikiria.
Especially if he's not clean.
Kwa kusema ukweli
hawakuwa. And you're all dolled up going to the office because you have a special meeting with your partners.
Na wewe unaenda kwa ofisi ukiwa msafi sana kwa sababu
uko. Now arrive at the office.
Kutano. Alafu unafika kwa ofisi.
And your day is already just ruined in the morning.
Siku yako unasikia iliharibiwa kutoka asubuhi.
And then among the partners that have come to your meeting that day.
Alafu ule mtu ambaye anakuja kwa hiyo meeting siku hiyo.
Is this young man that you have ever seen in several meetings before?
Ni huyu mtu ambaye umewahi muona kwa mikutano.
And you have already filled in the mental forms in your mind that he's born again and spirit filled.
Na tayari umeshasikia kwa roho yako huyu mtu ameokoka.
Even though you have never seen him again.
Hata kama hujawahi muona tena.
You look at him and by the way he's dressed you can tell that this one speaks in tongues 3 times a day.
Hata ukimwangalia vile amevaa unasema huyu kweli anaongea na dimi
siku. And then just as you're sitting down during the break.
Na hapo kama umeketi tu wakati umetulia.
The young man tells you, "I love the way you're dressed."
Huyo mtu anakuja anakuambia napenda vile umevaa.
You cannot stand to go and add your cup of tea because your knees are weak.
Uwezi simama uende ukakunywa chai kwa sababu miguu yako imechanga.
The first person in the matatu told you they love the whole of you.
Ule mtu wa matatu alikwambia nakupenda vile uko.
You will not even pay him 2 cents of attention.
Hata hukumsikiliza hata kidogo.
The other one just told you they love the way you are dressed. To me, even if your clothes were hung outside without you in them, he will still like the way they look.
Ule mwingine amekwambia tu nimependa vile umevaa.
But that one from that person, it carries more weight. You're feeling like, my goodness.
Huyo unasikia ni kama amebeba uzito sana.
Why is that?
Kwa nini?
It must be because it matters who loves you.
Ni kwa sababu inalingana na yule anayekupenda.
Now I wonder why that does not resonate with us.
Neno ambalo tunaenda kusoma.
I wonder why it does not resonate with us. Why it does not hit home with us.
Nashangaa kwa nini hili neno hatulifanya hata nyumbani.
When it is the savior of the world that is saying.
Ya kwamba ni yule mwokozi wa ulimwengu.
There is a certain way I have loved you.
Kuna vile ambavyo nilikupenda.
Look, I died for you.
Angalia nilikufa kwa sababu yako.
I paid it all for you.
Nililipa yote kwa sababu yako.
He says in Colossians chapter 2 verse 15, I tore the warrant of arrest.
Inasema ya kwamba nilikupenda.
That now there is no legal claim against you.
Ya kwamba hakuna kinyume.
I took it all on myself so that you don't have to take it again a single day.
Nilikubeba ili usiwahi lipa tena.
But for some sad reason.
Lakini kwa bahati mbaya.
When he says I have loved you.
Anaposema nakupenda.
It's just like some other chorus you're hearing in the matatu.
Ni kama zile sauti ambazo umezoea kusikia kwa matatu.
Why do you think that is so?
Kwa nini unafikiria ni hivyo?
Oh, how I pray that in this year of open heavens. Yeah. That the eyes of your understanding shall also be open.
Ya kwamba
that you may see who has loved you. Paul, writing to the church at Ephesus in Ephesians chapter 1 verse 16 through down, he says that, I pray that the eyes of your understanding shall be flooded with light, that you may be able to see the hope of his calling, that you may be able to see the glorious of the inheritance of his riches, inheritance, that you may be able to see the power, the mighty power that's at work, that the eyes of your understanding shall be open, brethren, because it matters who loves you. Because that is what made sense to Jesus. That is what made Jesus arise, even though it was in his final hours, and go and clean the dusty, smelly feet of his disciples. Now you might say that those feet were not smelly because they were wearing sandals. But you and I both know.
Lakini mimi na wewe tunaelewa.
If you were to just do a round trip to Gikomba and back,
kama umetoka hapa kuenda Gikomba
sandals,
na kurudi,
in this hot Nairobi summer,
na umevaa slippers kwa hii Nairobi,
we will not
joto ya Nairobi,
we will not breathe. We will not breathe next to you.
Hautaweza hata kupumua karibu.
But that was not a deterrent to Jesus.
Lakini hiyo haikujalisha kwa Yesu.
Why? Because he was empowered by the person that had loved him first.
Kwa sababu alikuwa amepewa nguvu na yule aliyempenda zaidi.
So now he's able to do the thing that God has sent him to do.
Kwa hivyo sasa anaweza fanya ile kitu ambayo Mungu alimwambia.
So he goes right down and he washes their dirty smelly feet.
Kwa hivyo anainama na kuosha hiyo miguu ya wanafunzi.
And he does not discriminate.
Na hata habagui.
Actually, immediately after this, Judas arises and leaves.
Hata baada ya hii, Yudasi anaamka na anatoka.
But even though Jesus knew that already,
hata kama Yesu alikuwa anajua,
did not stop him from washing those feet.
Hakukosa kumuosha miguu yake.
Because it matters who loves you.
Kwa sababu inalingana ni nani anayekupenda.
When we were praying earlier here, just as we were beginning,
tuliomba hapa tukianzia,
we said that it is okay for you to be loved by other people.
Tulisema ni sawa kupendwa na wengine.
In fact, it is your responsibility to love other people.
Hata ni jukumu lako kupenda wengine.
But every human form of affection,
ya kwamba kila mtu umuonyeshe hiyo upendo,
is temporal at best. Every form of human love is temporal at best.
Kila upendo wa kila mtu ni kwa muda tu.
Yesterday we attended a certain panel at University of Nairobi.
Jana tulitembea University of Nairobi.
And the people that were married were able to tell us, even when you're married,
na hata wale watu ambao wameoa walikuwa wanatuambia hata wakati umeoa,
there are days that you feel alone.
Kuna wakati unajisikia upweke.
Kwanza, there are days that you have arguments.
Kuna wakati mnakuwa na marudishiano.
And for a whole week you are not talking.
Na kwa wiki mzima hamuongelesheani.
Oh, for a day, yeah, because you believe, Bible practicing believers do not go to bed angry, you know. So for a day you're not talking to each other.
Kwa siku mzima hamuongelesheani kwa sababu unajaribu kufanya.
But that was the person you came to church and you said changu chote na kushirikisha wewe.
Na wewe ndio ule ulikuja kanisani ukasema,
because you love them deeply.
Kwa sababu ulikuwa unampenda zaidi.
Yes, in that moment you're feeling like you're alone and empty and you're wondering, what was I thinking?
Wakati unajisikia uko peke yako, hauna matumaini.
Because it doesn't matter what human being has loved you, even though they look like they are tongue speaking, demon chasing, heaven bound and you know all those things, even that one is temporal at best.
Hata wakati unasikia upweke watu wanakuweka chini.
Oh, but beloved, there is a love. There is a love far above every love that we have known or known not. His name is Jesus. This love has a name. Oh, you can call on that name at whatever time. Scripture says in Psalm 46, he's an ever-present help in time of need. When you feel like you need this emptiness to just be filled, he's present. When you feel like you're so full and you're flowing, he's present. It
it matters who loves you.
Inajalisha ni nani anayekupenda.
I don't know who is loving you today.
Sijui ni nani anakupenda siku ya leo.
But I pray that over and above that person or those people.
Lakini naomba ya kwamba upendo huo utakuwa juu ya wale watu wanaokupenda.
Jesus above every other.
Yesu ako juu ya mwingine yote.
Is loving you especially differently.
Anakupenda zaidi na tofauti sana.
Because by the time Jesus is saying these words.
Kwa sababu wakati Yesu alikuwa anasema hii maneno.
If you read the whole of John chapter 13, several times it says that his heart was troubled.
Ukisoma Yohana 13 yote.
It says his heart was troubled.
Ilikuwa inasema ya kwamba roho yake ilikuwa inafadhaika.
It says that he was troubled in his spirit.
Alikuwa anafadhaika roho yake.
So it is possible for these things to be happening, but even then, because Jesus knew from where he came from and where he was going, he knew who had loved him. He had been approved and affirmed. He had accepted the love of Jesus inside of him.
Yesu alikuwa anajua mahali ametoka na mahali anaenda, na alikuwa ameshapokea ule upendo wa Mungu.
It was easy for him.
Ilikuwa rahisi kwake.
Number two and final.
Ya pili na ya mwisho.
It matters who you love.
Na inalingana ni nani unapenda.
You see, it's easy for us to think many different things about that line, that it matters who you love.
Ni rahisi sisi kufikiria mambo mengine, lakini inalingana ni nani unayependa.
But man, I love Jesus.
Lakini yule anayependa Yesu.
I love Jesus.
Mimi napenda Yesu.
Because Jesus was the real MVP. Jesus used to just shut things down.
Kwa sababu Yesu ana uwezo wa kufunga mambo yote.
Because listen what Jesus says.
Hii maneno Yesu akasema.
It is, I give you this commandment, love one another.
Nawapatia hii amri, mpende mwingine.
He doesn't say love your friend. He doesn't say love just the people that make you happy.
Hasemi eti penda wale ambao wanakufurahisha.
He doesn't put a cap on it. He doesn't put a lid on it.
Yani haweki limit ya kuambia penda huyu lakini
sasa. He says love one another.
Anasema penda mwingine kwa mwingine.
Is that one?
Iyo.
Is that another?
Huyo mwingine.
Please, you must love them.
Wapende wote.
Turn to your neighbor, ask them, are you one?
Pindukia
turn to another one, ask them, are you another?
Mulize ni wewe.
Oh, I must love you.
Ama ni lazima nikupende.
It doesn't matter what they are doing to you.
Haijalishi vile
wanakufanyia. You must love these people.
Lazima uwapende.
We must be known for the quality of love.
Lazima uwapende na ule upendo wa juu.
As believers, we must be known for love.
Kama waumini, lazima tukue na upendo.
Maybe the solution in your family is that you just need to love one more person.
Hii ndio jibu ya familia yetu ya kwamba tupende wengine.
Even in just praying for them.
Hata kuwaombea.
You cannot tell me for the single people in the house that you're waiting for somebody to get together with you to start a future with, and you're waiting for somebody to love with all your might, and you cannot love the person that you have a grudge with. Never gonna happen. And if it happens, it's going to be a solid failure. Because you will have this person fine. But there's a part of you that's going to be missing. Because you have been called to be a disciple. And you will not be known as a disciple until you have learned to love
others.
It doesn't matter how many miracles you work. It does not matter how much you serve.
Haijalishi unatumika kiasi gani.
And I might see you and you might look like you're serving great in the youth ministry.
Naweza kuona ni kama unatumika sana katika uongozi.
But there's one that is the design of the hearts and the minds of men.
Lakini kuna ile kitu ambacho umengojea.
And he's able to see your heart.
Yule aliye juu ako na uwezo wa kuona roho.
If the way you're serving is not coming from a place of love and ending at a place of love, not love plus other things.
Vile unafanya kama haitoki katika upendo, haipendezi kama.
You're lost. You are lost. You are lost.
Umepotea.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Listen. My time is up.
Sikiliza.
But allow me to say this one thing.
Wakati wangu umeisha.
Allow me to say this one thing.
Nikubalie kusema hivi.
Jesus says.
Yesu anasema.
Love one another.
Penda mwingine.
And he did not stop there. It will be so different if he had said love one another.
Hakumalizia tu hapo, lakini alisema penda mwingine kwa mwingine.
Because I will say now, I love you. atakama umenikosea, so I will spare your life and not kill you.
Kwa sababu nitasema ya kwamba nakupenda atakama umenikosea, sitakuua nitakuacha.
And I will say, I will never talk to you again, I will never see you again, in fact you are dead to me, but I will not kill you because.
Lakini nitasema sitawahi kuongelesha, sitawahi taka kukutana na wewe, lakini sitakumaliza.
Outside at your flat you will say,
hapo nje ya plot yetu utasema,
mtu akiwa ameanika nguo zake kwa kamba zako. You will come and you will say,
utakuja useme,
that because I love you,
kwa sababu nakupenda,
I'm not going to burn your clothes,
sitachoma manguo yako,
nimezitoa tu nikaziangusha chini. At least you can just wash them, but because kama singekuwa nakupenda ningezichoma zote. I know some of us are feeling tagged, but the truth of the matter is this.
Lakini ukweli ni kwamba
Jesus knew that if he left it to us,
Yesu alijua ya kwamba
through our own interpretation we do those kinds of shenanigans.
Kwa sisi tukijaribu kutafsiri ni kama hivi.
But he said to us,
lakini alisema,
love one another,
penda huyo mwingine,
as I have loved you,
kama vile nilivyowapenda.
He is the example.
Yeye ndiye mfano.
You cannot love using the example of the other people.
Uwezi penda ukitumia mfano wa wengine.
In fact, you get into a relationship, you cannot love as your couple. See, we have couple goals.
Hata
mkielekea
kuoana.
See, we have couple goals. Goals.
Tuko na ile mafikio kama watu waliooana.
Pia hiyo ni sawa. If for instance Pastor Kibera and Esther, Pastor Kibera and Esther are married, yeah? If I think that their relationship is beautiful,
nikifikiria uhusiano wao unapendeza sana,
I will say couple goals.
Nitasema
yes, sasa.
Ndio. Shabaha ni ndoa yao. Lengo ni ndoa yao.
Amen.
Yeah, shabaha la kindoa. Kwa kweli jamani, ndio hiyo sasa. Shabaha la kindoa ndio hiyo. Hiyo tulifunzwa na mama ya Pastor Beatrice, shabaha. Sasa even for those kinds of people, you cannot love the person that you're relating with just like at your couple goals. The example is Jesus.
Mfano wako ni Yesu.
Bwana, I know it sounds a bit rigid.
Najua inakaa.
But it is the safe way to do life.
Lakini ni vizuri kufanya.
Come on, I said it is the safe way to do life. In fact, it is the assured way to get results.
Ndio ile njia mzuri ya kupata.
Because it doesn't matter how much Kibera and Esther love each other.
Kwa sababu haijalishi Kibera na Esther wanapendana kiwango gani.
You do not know them behind closed doors.
Haujui wakishaingia huko ndani.
We catch them with the eye of discernment.
Tunawaona tu huko.
And we see their spirit-filled, demon chasing, tongues speaking, heaven bound.
Tunaona wale watu wanaongea na dimu wanafukuza.
At the end of the day, when they go back to their own house, though.
Lakini wakienda huko nyumbani.
And you see, when you've been married for as long as Esther and Kibera, you know how to disagree silently.
Unajua kuna vile
such that even their children will not be able to catch what they are talking about. So utasikia tu, unasikia tu. Unasikia tu kule ndani manunguniko. I am using the example because they are great friends of mine.
Na watumia mfano kwa sababu ni rafiki zangu sana.
So you cannot afford to use human beings.
Kwa hivyo huwezi chukua mfano wa mtu mwingine.
Listen, Hebrews chapter 4 verse 15 says, but we have a high priest.
Yakumba tuko na kuhani mkuu.
Who is not untouched by the feeling of our infirmities.
Ule ambaye haguzwi na mafikirio
hapa. But he was tested in every way as we are.
Lakini alijaribiwa.
This is my favorite part, yet without sin.
Yakumba hata kwa hiyo hakuwa.
So Jesus is goals for everything, ladies and gentlemen.
Yesu ndiye.
And if I am looking to love and be loved,
na tunaweza mtafuta ili atupende na tumpende.
If they cannot love me like Jesus loves me, I don't know what we are doing.
Kama uwezi nipenda vile Yesu ambaye ananipenda.
If I cannot love you the way Jesus loves me, I'm still missing the mark. Romans chapter 13. I will still be missing the mark.
Utakuwa bado unapoteza mwelekeo.
Because I must seek to love you like Jesus.
Lazima nikupende kama Yesu.
He says, as I have loved you.
Inasema kama vile niliwapenda.
As I have loved you.
Kama vile nilivyowapenda.
How will you learn to love like Jesus?
Sasa na sisi tujue kupenda kama Yesu.
I know we are done with 40 days of prayer and fasting.
Unajua tumeshamaliza kuomba maombi ya siku 40.
But you're not going to learn to love like Jesus by just sitting away from Jesus.
Lakini hatutakaa tujue kupenda kama
you must sit down before him.
Lazima ukae chini na yeye.
Long enough for him to deposit the way to love him.
Utake sana kujua kupenda kama yeye.
Not for 2 minutes or for 10 minutes.
Sio kwa dakika mbili ama kumi.
Not for 1 hour or for 3 hours.
Sio kwa lisali moja ama masaa matatu.
For nice chunks of time, not 1 day or 2 days, for the rest of your life.
Sio siku moja, siku mbili, lakini maisha yako.
You must dedicate some time to spend in the presence of God.
Lazima utafute wakati wa kukaa karibu na Mungu.
Lamentations chapter 3 verse 26 onward says it is good for you to bear the yoke in your youth.
Ni vizuri wewe kubeba mzigo ukiwa mkitana.
It says let that man sit silently and patiently before God.
Wacha huyo mtu akae karibu na Mungu.
So that he can be able to speak to you.
Ili akaweze kukuongelea.
Because if he says as I have loved you,
kwa sababu Biblia inasema kama vile nilivyowapenda.
The only way for you to love that, for you to understand or to get that as, is for you to sit before him.
Jambo tu la kupenda kama Yesu ni kukaa karibu na yeye.
You cannot be in a hurry in God's class.
Uwezi kuwa una haraka ukiwa karibu na
Mungu. I said you cannot be in a hurry in God's class.
Uwezi kuwa na haraka ukiwa katika.
You cannot be in a hurry. I know you're feeling like your time is running out and your patience is running out and this person is wronging you over and over again. You cannot be in a hurry in God's class.
Uwezi kuwa na haraka katika.
I know you're feeling like any time now you will do something in that organization. You will just do something because your boss is getting on your last nerves. You cannot be in a hurry in God's class.
Unasikia ni kama uko karibu kufanya kitu, lakini uwezi kuwa na haraka katika darasa la Mungu.
Let me wind up with this illustration.
Wacha nimalizie hivi.
Most of us are computer literate.
Watu wengi tumesoma computer.
Anytime you want to download or to copy a file.
Wakati unaopenda kuandika.
To copy a file. To transfer documents from the computer to your flash disk.
Yeah, kutoa kitu fulani kuipeleka kwa flash disk.
Yes. Unaenda kwa kompyuta yako, unachukua, unaeka flash disk yako, unaingiza, then unasema copy files, transfer, copy to this flash disk. That's what we do, right? Ukianza kufanya hivyo, there is a status bar that appears there. Then, is it status or task bar? What is it called? Yeah, that thing, whatever it's called, it's a bar, all right? So, that bar, that thing, it is showing you progress. Inakuonyesha ambavyo hii kituo inasonga. Inakuonyesha it is remaining, 13 minutes remaining, 12 minutes remaining, 10 minutes remaining. It is copying files. Sawa sawa diapo. Now, what happens if you are to take the flash disk and chomoa it before it is done copying?
Kama unataka kutoa hiyo flash disk kabla haijamalizia.
Some of the files will have been copied.
Vitu zingine zitakuwa tayari zimewekwa.
Some of them will not have copied.
Zingine zitapotea.
If you are copying a movie, for instance.
Kama unaandika movie.
When you are, as you are copying and you chuck the flash disk.
Kama ulikuwa unakopi hiyo movie alafu unaitoa.
Some files will appear like they are there, but they are not there. They are corrupt files. They are incomplete files. That's the
word. Vitu zingine zitaonekana lakini hazitakuwa zimekamilika.
That is exactly what happens every time we sit in the presence of God and are in a hurry.
Hivyo ndivyo inafanyikanga wakati tumekaa karibu na Mungu lakini tuko na haraka.
Because the Lord is starting to download things into your life.
Kwa sababu Yesu ameanza kufanya mambo katika maisha yako.
He's starting to give you instructions.
Anaendelea kukupatia mawaidha.
He's starting to tell you leave that boy alone.
Anakuambia uacha huyo.
He's starting to tell you take this person.
Anakuambia chukua huyu mtu.
But before he is done with his sentence, you have
lakini
already withdrawn.
Kabla amalizie sentence yake umeshajitoa.
And you're already out and about, already taking this person that God has said take this person.
Na wewe unatoka unasema Mungu amesema nichukue huyu.
But listen.
Sikiliza.
You did not finish copying the instruction.
Haukumalizia kuandika mawaidha.
Maybe God was saying take this person aside.
Labda Mungu alikuwa anakuambia chukua huyu mtu muweke kando.
But you in your mighty rush, you just take this person.
Ukiwa na haraka unasema Mungu amesema chukua huyu mtu.
And then you come and you start telling us, "Oh, I was praying and the Lord said, kwani how does God work? Because me I had God saying very clearly take this person." He was not done.
Alafu ulikuwa
where were you going?
Unakuja kusema
where were you going?
Ulikuwa unaenda wapi?
And that's just one example, brethren. Every time you're worrying about the issue of love, whether it is loving your parents, some of you need to leave this place and sit before God and tell God, God, I know what has happened between me and my father. I know what has happened between me and my mother. I know what has happened between me and my siblings. I know what has happened between me and my boss, between me and my neighbors. I know what is happening between me and the cell leader in my church. I know what is happening between me and my zonal leader. I know what is happening between me and that boy or me and that girl. I know what is happening. But Lord, I know I had a half instruction. Please, I am back here. Delete everything else. Let's start afresh. Some of us need to do that when we
leave. Mungu mwambie, Mungu najua hii mambo venye ilifanyika, lakini nimerudi tena unisungumzie tena.
Because the way we are suffering is not because God cannot handle our situation.
Kwa sababu vile ambavyo unaendelea kuteseka si mpango wa Mungu.
It's because we are not patient enough for him to
focus. Ni kwa sababu hatujakuwa wa kuongojea Mungu.
Love one another.
Penda mmoja kwa mwingine.
As I have loved you.
Kama vile nilivyowapenda.
The only way for you to love like Jesus.
Njia moja tu ya kupenda kama Yesu.
Is to sit long enough in his class.
Ni kukaa masaa mingi sana katika darasa lake.
For him to teach you his model.
Ili yeye akufundishe njia zake.
For him to show you not just the way how to do it but the way to do it.
Ili yeye akuonyeshe sio tu kuifanya lakini njia ya kuifanya.
The only way for you to love not just people, even love things, even to love ministry, to love God, even for you to love him, how will you be able to love God unless he teaches you how to do it? The Bible says that God is love. He's patient, he's kind, he gives way, what is the other? Love is patient, love is kind, love is, yeah, that love is powerful, love is anointed, okay, love is for all those things that God is. The only way for you to know how to love, surely, if God is love, then how, where are you getting the other examples for loving?
Kama Mungu ni upendo, tunapokea mfano mwingine kutoka wapi?
I just give you a minute to ask the Lord, God, please help me to love like
nataka
you.
Nikupatie wakati mdogo uongee na Mungu.
I know as we were speaking, the Holy Spirit was showing you, this is where you got it wrong, right here. You're in trouble with this person because you got it wrong. You're in trouble with this person because you are refusing to take the example of Jesus. You're in trouble with this person because you thought you got the instruction, but then now you're in trouble. Go back to God right in this instance. You'll not have all the time to sort it all out here right now because you don't need a shortcut. What you need is the proper working scheme, the proper working way, and that you can only get from a good time in fellowship with the Holy Spirit, not just in one instance.
Wakati mzuri wa kushirikiana.
Come on, lift up your voice and you're asking God to just help. If you have nothing to say, just say, Lord, have mercy. Lord, help me. Lord, I'm drowning. Lord, I need you. Lord, I cannot do this without you. If it is a command that I shall be known as your disciple in the way I love other people, in the way I love others, in the way we love one another. The only way, Lord, is to love one another, and I don't know how to do it. Help me, Lord Jesus. Father, in the precious name of Jesus, we thank you because you're right here in this room today. We thank you because you have spoken to us in accents clear and still. We thank you, dear God, because this is just, oh God, a brief public word, oh God. But we know that your Holy Spirit has the power to follow it up into our homes, into our offices, into our rooms, into the public spaces, into our public transport, into the places where we live, into our flats, into our compounds and our estates. Your Spirit, dear God, is able to follow it up into our home, into our family gatherings. It is able to follow us up even into our own private rooms, because some of us are struggling to love other people. We don't even know how to love ourselves. We have not even accepted, because we have not understood that it matters who loves us and that it matters that we love other people. It matters the people that we love. You have commanded us to love everybody. Lord, I pray by the power of your Holy Spirit, because that is a big, big, huge assignment, to love one another as you have loved us. It is not possible for us to do it alone. Help us, O Holy Spirit of God. Help us, because we need your help. We cannot do this alone. If you do not help us, we will absolutely drop the baton. We will ruin the entire thing. We will burn it all up, oh God, and we do not want to do that. Therefore, remember mercy and help us. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.